happy weekend. We made it to the end of a jam-packed week full of news, but there are still some news highlights you need to know about that I'm going to dish for you in your daily afternoon news brief for WBOM. According to officials with the Madison County Detention Center, Wednesday night, three overdoses occurred within the jail. All three were females and were taken to the hospital for treatment. Additionally, two of the three had to be brought back after apparently dying from the supposed ingestion of the drug, which is still unspecified at this time. Jailer Steve Tussey says that because of the jail staff, the life-saving of these inmates would not have been possible. Jailer Tussey also told WBON that Narcan was administered and the women were revived and then transported to Baptist Health. After observation, they were then taken back to the jail, and he reports that the investigation is still active. Therefore, no more charges have been filed at this time. Just days after the grand opening of a new downtown business, Tila's Kentucky Sandwich Shack, the owner is in jail and awaiting extradition to Illinois. Police are acting on an anonymous tip, which arrested DeJean Mack, also known as Marshawn Thomas, on multiple charges, including aggravated armed robbery and possession of cannabis over 30 grams. He told local news outlets in a jailhouse interview that he is willing to accept the punishment and that he did save up money to open the sandwich shop and then hopes to serve the time and return to his business. At the moment, the shop on 2nd Street will remain open under the store's manager. And Madison Middle School was one of two middle school bands selected to perform at the 2019 Kentucky Music Educators Association Conference. Carrie Evans, band director, is in his 13th year and won not only the Citation of Excellence Award, as well as the KMEA District 11 Middle School Teacher of the Year. Mr. Evans and the band won a certificate of recognition for outstanding musicianship and performance from the National Band Association. And the Richmond Senior Citizen Center held their annual Valentine's Chili Cook-Off today at Central Bank in Richmond. The event includes auction for purses and other items. Director Heather Sloan explained that all the fundraisers' proceeds will benefit the Richmond Senior Center in the video up now on WBONTV.com. Heather said that aside from the auction, volunteers provided food such as chili, spaghetti, and various desserts. Although the annual event is hosted at Central Bank each year, they are hoping that someday the Senior Citizen Center will be big enough for an event like this. The successful event raised over $25,000 last year, and their most successful fundraiser of all time totaled $35,000. For more stories such as these, be sure to visit Richmond's very own WBONTV.com. I'm Marissa Hempel.